Potter City presents Open Heavens, 40 Days Fasting and Prayer, Theme, Higher Dimensions,
your host,
Prophet Nanase Opokusakodie.
Whatever God is, his word is. You can't separate God from his word. God's power is in his word. His power is domiciled in his word. So when you receive the word, you have received power. Now hear this. I am not ashamed of the gospel, says apostles. And they say, why? He said, because it's the career of the power of God unto salvation to them that believe. Today, may the Lord move you from revelation to illumination.
Amen.
It's not the same. It's not the same. Hallelujah. It's one thing for it to be revealed. It's another thing for you to be illuminated in your spirit. The entrance of God's word brings light. It gives understanding to the simple. So the word comes, you open your heart, you cut it up, it enters your heart. Every darkness disappears. Now hear this. The word is called the sword of the spirit. The sword of the spirit. A sure word of prophecy. A sure word of, he said, heaven and earth will pass away by my word. I love something about the word. And the word was made flesh. Hear this. And the word was on my heart. It has power to change itself. It has power to transform itself from liquid to solid. It can catapult itself. The word was made flesh. It means it can create kidneys. Somebody there. The word can create a liver. The word can give you a new womb. That is why Jesus made somebody born blind and spit on the ground and anointed his
head.
In the beginning was the word. The word was with God. The word was God. So you can't separate God from his word. No, your greatest challenge is lack of word in your spirit. That's why I told you that. You cannot be a faith giant without being a word addict. The authentic source of faith is God's word. So show me a man who has appetite for God's word, and I will show you a faith giant. How does it come? If you don't have faith, it's very simple. God has shown how you can get it. Faith comes by hearing and hearing, not your husband telling you stories. Not your boyfriend squeezing you in your car. Playing Taliban catch a song. Faith comes by what? Yeah. So once I'm preaching, faith can be fired into your heart. Pastor Martin sent me some interesting testimony. It's long, I couldn't finish reading it. About a guy that the word was fired onto. Maybe later you have to read it to them. It has moved the guy from nations. He's moving the one way. He has been a word traveler.
Hey.
One way. Today, your local championship status will change immediately. Somebody say the word.
The word.
No, that's it. Once you cut the word, that's it. It can revolutionize your life.
Yes.
The word was made flesh. The word was made flesh. The word was. Jesus Christ came in the form of the flesh, loaded with the word. And the word was made flesh. So whatever you don't have, the word can create it. Can create it. Can create it. It can create it. I've seen the word make people's hand grow. I've seen it. I've seen it. The word. The word was coming. The Bible says Jesus was preaching and teaching, and the presence of the Lord was there to him. But he was not singing, he was preaching. And once the word was coming, it was breaking every satanic stronghold. The devil can't stand it. The weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal. Every denier of the word is a major attack. It's a major attack. The way you don't like to read the Bible, that is the beginning of your struggle. You can't help anybody who cannot accept Bible solution for their problem. Okay, do you have marital problem? Get to the word.
Yeah.
You and your husband shouldn't be fighting. Get to the word. What does the Bible say about you, your responsibility to your wife? Love her. It didn't say when he respects you. It's as simple as that. Submit to your husband. He didn't say when the man is rich. He can be broke as a church man. Submit. Simple. Now hear me. According to the word, when the cycle of love and submission break, you don't have marriage, you have roommate. It's not there. You don't have marriage anymore. It's like when Elizabeth was in tech and was in something hall, Katanga something, roommate, hallelujah. But yours, in your case, a woman and a man. When the cycle of husband love your wife, as Christ loved the church, so to love your wife, you must go and check how Christ was loving the church. The standard is very high. Jesus Christ has never divorced one of his wives. Like you who be sitting here. Never. With all your spiritual prostitution, he still receive you. Somebody said what I'm talking about. And he said, love your wife as Christ loved the church. As simple as that. Your problem is accepting the Bible solution for your problem. That is your major problem. Don't let the guy squeeze you when you are caught in. It's as simple as that. It's as a caught in purity. And you enjoy trust in marriage. It's as simple as that. The way he's squeezing you, that's the way after he marry you, when you see him walking with somebody, you think he's going to squeeze the person. No, because trust is a process. Now hear me. In the Old Testament, when a city is walled, it's protected. You remember, Nehemiah traveled to just go and build the walls of Jerusalem, that's all. When they have to go to Jericho, Jericho was strictly shut up. Wall, fence, 7 horses can ride on the wall. So Jericho wall width probably can be like this auditorium. And they were there. When the city is walled, it's protected. When the city is not walled, it's vulnerable to any external attack. So the security of those countries is that they are walled. The population was not like this one. Maybe its old city can be like, you just want to go to Israel, you go and see the old city. You see the old city where we have all the Jaffa Gate and the Lion's Gate and all that. So when we see a country, that is what we see over there. Are you getting it? So let's say in those days, the whole Potter City can be a city. Yes. That's what it is. War. Now, when the city is war, it's protected. When the city is not war, it's vulnerable. As the wars those days were around the city, so the word of God is a word around a believer. It's a shadow of things to come. So when you don't have the word, you are vulnerable to every satanic assault. As simple as that. So you know what any man of God is teaching when they say, I can only preach the word. Jesus Christ talk about the different heart that receive the word. He said, you can receive the word in your heart like the seed that is fall on the wayside. Some of them receive it like the seed that is fall on the rocky ground. Among them, some of them to receive it on a seed on the good ground. The Bible says it bear fruit 150 and it bear multiple fruit. So the state of your heart determines how the word of God will be fruitful. Amen. The Lord, I clap off and I'm preaching. Hallelujah. After 40 days of fasting, every breakthrough you are going to get must be protected by the word. You use the word to get a breakthrough. You use the word to protect and defend it. Without the word, the devil walk into your house and get it. It's called the sword of the spirit. He fears. Do you know that when Satan tempted Jesus, he didn't say, I bind you? Never. Jesus never said, I bind you. He said, It is written. Woe unto you when your enemies knock your door and you don't know what is written. You can be a pastor and not know the word. What are you talking about? You can be a deacon and you are zero. They gave you deacon position because you have money. The time of trial come, you'll be off. One Legon girl will take you out of the post straight. Because you are not solid in the word. Do you know why you are fornicating? You don't have the word. No? There are two reasons why you are living in sin. Number one, you don't have the picture of your future. If God show you a dream that you are going to be a prime minister, you will never sleep with Mrs. Potiphar. Bishop, it's as simple as that. He saw the stars and the moon, they were bowing. Jacob said, will me and your mother also come and bow? Now, sir, do you know why you are living in sin? You don't have the picture of your future. When God told me at full gospel meeting, Cocoa Research Institute, with my uncle that I'll become born again few weeks. This guy will be a man of God. This guy will be a servant of God. He will be preaching the gospel. Ah. It fired purity inside me. No, the prophecy is not the way we give it to you. Accurate, we are taking it for granted. No. Hallelujah. It fired purity inside me. Some of you are getting prophetic word. The day you get it, that day you say. The day a prophecy to your boyfriend came to take you at, after prayer and after all night, after crossing 12 o'clock, and squeeze you to bone before he leave. How can a prophecy come to pass? Hallelujah. How can it? No word. He said, thy word have I hid in my heart. Where do you hide the word? In a, so hear me. The Bible you carry, the Bible you are holding, huh? This Pharisee Bible, it carries no power until it enters your heart. You can have 34 Bibles. Huh? Now, listen, it's not a matter of reading 20 chapters a day. How much of them has entered your spirit? As simple as that. It's as simple as that. Of you carry Bible for show. Hallelujah. The Pharisee Bible, when you are coming, small boy is carrying it in front of you. How much of the word is in your spirit? It's as simple as that. The size of your Bible does not determine the size of your blessing. Amen. Are you there? The word. Tell somebody the word. It will help you to marry well. The word will make you a celebrated husband. The word will make you unforgettable wife. The word. Your husband can't go anywhere. He goes from the office. He is quick to come home. Leaving you 6 hours is like leaving you 6 years. But for you to develop that thing we call virtuous woman, it is based on the word. You can't get it from tech. You can't get it from Lego. That's somebody's word. Man of God, you can't pastor successfully without the word. It is the word that sent her to Porter City. Arise, it's time to build a city. Word. Jeremiah chapter 30:18. We were in Tema. Patasi. When the word of the Lord came to me, Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 18. Listen, this is the word. Thus saith the Lord, behold, I will bring again the captivity of all the Porterian's tent and have mercy on his dwelling place. That's the word that brought us here, Apostle. I'll show you. Verse 19 is the word we carry on here. That is the word that brought us here, that everybody was afraid. One man of God said, you have lost your mind. Somebody told me, say, this guy can hear God again. How can you bring a church here? Have you lost your mind? Who's going to follow you there? By the way, hear this. And have mercy on the dwelling place. And the city shall be built upon her own heap. And the palaces shall remain after the manner thereof. The city. So when I came here, I know it is a city. Now look at verse 90. The city is what brought us here. Out of them shall proceed thanksgiving. And the voice of them that make merry. We were few. I will multiply them. They will not be few. They shall not be few. I will glorify them. They shall never be small.
Hey.
So the word fire. This is the word. If I don't tell you, you don't know that is in my spirit. That is the word that brought us here. So I am not looking for who is here, who is not here.
Yes.
That's why it's not my business. Just have to obey God. Okay. I will multiply them. They will not be few. So a time is coming that this ground cannot contain the crowd that God is bringing. Don't you see the steady growth of this thing going? I will multiply. Did you hear what I said? Now hear this. The voice of them that make merry. Out and out of them shall proceed thanksgiving. That is why we are in constant appreciation. Do you know what it is? We came here. There were 5 people praying. Lord, thank you for bringing 5. Nobody should have even come at all. Out of them shall. Do you know why you are diminishing? Because you are not appreciative. To go and say, Lord, why didn't you bring the people? Thank you for bringing somebody. Thank you that 3 people came. Thank you that 5 people came. Thank you. Those days, we were doing all the programs in House of Faith. House of Faith, morning session, half full. And I was celebrating God for bringing somebody. I thank him. Lord, they've passed all the big churches. They have come here. To you be all the glory. The way you tell God, we look at the people you brought. God says, hey, with all your nonsense, I brought people. And we were saying this one. I remember my wife opened a shop in Osu many years ago. We were there. When we opened the shop, was high expectation. And two people show up. He came back very quiet, deep place. People didn't come. I said, you should be thanking God. He said, thank God for what? I said, you want to kill the shop? Because somebody has opened shop 1 week, nobody has entered. If two people have come to you, you should be celebrating God for bringing two. That is the only way you increase. That is the only way you increase. I was thanking God for a car with that starter, driving it comfortably. Pastor Martin and Terry is there. Comfortable. I was not ashamed to take it to church. I will put it where they will push it. No starter. No starter. Comfortably driving it and thanking God because somebody is walking. Did you hear what I'm talking about? That thing that you are accusing and you are murmuring and complaining, somebody wish he has it. In all things, give thanks. This is the reason you are not improving. Lord, I don't know why you have not given me a husband. Look at me and turn yourself in the mirror. I try to accuse God. If you don't have a nose, will you be looking for a husband? Have you seen a noseless woman looking for a husband? You should thank God that you are marriage worthy. Thank God, Lord, I am marriage worthy. I have my breast, I have my back, I have my chest, and thank you that my husband is coming. Now, may you step into the spirit of thanksgiving after this one.
Amen.
Some women would have taken seed long time if they learned appreciation. In your menses, you are thanking God. I thank you that you, all things are possible.
Thank you.
I even thank you that I'm able to menstruate. Thank you that this. And God is,
Gabriel,
look at that, my daughter. In the midst of all, look at the way Jesus raised somebody from the dead. John chapter 11. Jesus Christ went to the tomb of Lazarus. He is about to raise him from the dead. The quickest way to bring the dead back to life. Go to 40, let me see, 40. And Jesus said unto her, say that not to thee, that if thou wouldest believe, thou wouldest see the glory of God. Look at verse 41. And they took away the stone from the place where the dead was laid. And Jesus lifted up his hand and said, Father, this is the key that brought Lazarus from the dead. The man is still dead, and Jesus was thanking his father. Bam, God break him from. May you receive the spirit of thanksgiving in your spirit. This is the reason why you are diminishing. This is where today America is celebrating Thanksgiving. Does Ghana do one? So look at the way you are going down. America has been doing it for centuries. It's a day of thanking God for sustaining them. Ghana is always asking. It's dangerous to be a constant asking Christian. I'm teaching you all the counsel of God. You won't have an excuse tomorrow. You will never have an excuse how you will fail tomorrow. I'm telling you, I'm showing one of the major secrets of the expansion importance. Major secret. We were worshiping in house. These medical doctors were sleeping on the building that was no roof. Whilst rain was beating, I was thanking God. Thank you that the building is half roof. Thank you that. Now listen. We mounted the pulpit on this side. At the back there, the whole building was no roof. We were praying half roof because we couldn't have money to roof all of them. So half roof, and then we mounted the pulpit half on the side, and we were worshiping God in joy. And this boy will be thanking God that we had the privilege to worship in a roof that is not fully roof. Today, look at us. Look at us boiling in the central air condition everywhere. Look at us. This is the reason for your diminishing. Do you know mamas, they remember, and they were beaten by serpents? That's what it is. Murmuring removes the favor of God from your life.
I don't even know why I'm not married. I can't even tell why. I'm so beautiful, but men are not looking at me.
Who told you are beautiful? Have I told you? Who said you are beautiful? Who told you? That foolish boy told you are beautiful. You have added to your CV. Look at the ugliness of the boy that told you are beautiful. In the kingdom of the blind, the quarter is always the key. You need a handsome man like me to tell you you are beautiful. Who told you?
Yes.
You have added it to your CV. Instead of thanking God, Lord, I thank you. Your fiancé has left you. Lord, I don't know about this one, but thank you that you hold my future. You know what is best for me. I love him still, and I don't have any grudges against him. And you know what is better. My life is planned by you, and you want my life to go according to the way it is. I thank you for everything. And then you are not coming. I don't know why you, Lord. I've been paying my tithe. Even give prophet another seed. And my husband has loved me. Come and collect your seed back. Your life could have changed a long time. Some pastors are murmuring and complaining why people are not coming to church. That is why their church is not growing anywhere. No, this is one church in Ghana where you are coming, you travel. You don't go to church, you travel to church. Bishop, did you travel before you came here? You can set up from Kasua, by the time you arrive, somebody has reached Kofodia. Somebody has arrived. The same space. I have no right to mama when God brings two people. Because they pass through big churches to come here. Lord, thank you for the people you brought. We are so grateful. Your ministry could have changed long time. It's a major key. Jesus is Lord. I said, Jesus is Lord. I said, Jesus Christ is Lord. Somebody is there for this. You are standing on the tomb. CNN and BBC and Al Jazeera is putting camera on you. I mean, if you are you, we are going to need a kakuka kabaya. A kukre kakuye. Hey, death, command you. Father, I thank you. Receive grace to thank God for your finances. If you want to throw a money in your bank account, receive grace to thank God for the husband you have not seen. Receive grace to thank God for everything you are doing. No matter how it's going down, they fire you from the office, begin to thank God.
Thank God.
Only God can change the situation. Sit down. When I wake up in the morning, thank you for waking me up. Thank you for the strength you gave to me yesterday. I don't know what I'm going to do, but I still depend on you. By the time I stand here, it quickens my mortal body. I'm in the floor. Now, a complaining Christian has no future. The mama and they died at Kadesh Barnea. A spirit of appreciation could have changed your life a long time. Were there not 10 lepers that were healed? Where are they now? Where are they now? The one that came to thank him was made whole. Which means that when you are healed of leprosy, Uncle Joe, there will be still some scars in your body to see that you are a leper. But this one that came to thank him, his skin became like a baby's skin. Yeah. Let's give it. It's the key. Thanking God. I was thanking God for a car with that starter. How many cars do I have now? Hallelujah. Thanking God. I have sown seed to God, dangerous seed. When my wife is quiet for the seed I've sown, and I'm thanking God for the privilege to give. It's a privilege. Now let's say, when I didn't have trotro money from Odoko to Accra, where was I going to sow that seed? No. Your lack of appreciation is what has made your life stagnant. I was preaching to the married people. I told him that when your husband finished firing, thank him. Some of you are looking at me because not every woman is getting it that way. Somebody came to me and said, my husband has not touched me for 6 months. 6 months he has not touched me. Yesterday we ministered to a pastor here after honeymoon. He lost his potency for 6 years. Aren't you glad your potency is there? So listen, sometimes I start from my hair and all the parts I can remember, I thank God to my toe. Lord, I thank you for my brain. I thank you for my heart. I thank you for my liver. I thank you for my kidney. I thank you for my... I am thanking God for everything.
everyone.
That is why the devil cannot touch any part in my body. The secret of men are in their stories.
Yes, sir.
I curse every murmuring demon in your life.
Amen.
I curse every complaining spirit on your life.
Amen.
If you don't take it, the system will program you to be a complaining Christian. You will listen to radio stations and start talking like them. Are you getting it? I don't know any news. Somebody, my wife has to give me an update. I'm not listening to any nonsense. I am protecting my ear gate. Faith comes by hearing, and fear comes by hearing. So choose what you want to hear. If you were to thank God, you have married long time. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. I sit there and complaining. Unyan kopo. Mi hupo ni kwa mdiayo. Mi kundi mdiayo. Kachi Gabriel no me kanche mna mi enkasa na day my own day. Nobody is under pressure. A heart of appreciation. Show me a couple that is in constant thanksgiving, and I will show you a home to be envied. See the way we worship God here. I am not just a prophet, I'm a worshiper. The thing we do here is not that show you. We can do, I can wake up and worship. Yesterday I was in prayer. I sang for 1 hour, changing worship to one another, kneeling down a lying portrait. No instrument, no nothing. So it is what we do here is a rehearsal from what is in the bedroom. It's a lifestyle. That's how we live. If you are not a worshiper in your bedroom, you can't be a worshiper in church. Just flow naturally. Hallelujah. Naturally. Nobody walks in the spirit of thanksgiving and ever diminish. Nobody. Nobody. You know, Apostle Paul said, rejoice. And again, I say rejoice. In all things, give thanks. In all things. How many things? In all things. Your fiancé left you, give thanks. Your husband is not teaching you, give thanks. You will bury his pride. That is the spirit that God speak. Wiggins convicted. Convicted. Winter. He locked his wife in this. The wife was sleeping outside. Go and read the story. Apostle, the wife got up again. He said, go and sleep in that church. Lock him up. The woman was sleeping outside the church. Outside the front of when he came, the man has locked him. He banged, the guy would not open. Almost freeze like an ice block. When he woke up and he opened the door, the moment the woman woke up, if it is with you, what will happen? Your husband has locked the door. You go and bring all the carpenters. I'm telling you, break the door. The moment Smith opened the door, he again said, thank you, Smith, for a new day. What do you want me to do for breakfast? He went there, prepared his best breakfast. The guy was eating the thing with tears. He eat and cry. He eat and cry. While the house was thanking, he was crying. That is what got him convicted. He raised many people from the dead. Right? Smith, what is better? Some of his miracle was unusual. You know, in the olden days, when you have breast cancer, they show your hand and tie you to your breast like this. Those days. In the 40, they will tie it. They will tie your hand so your hand cannot be moved. He pulled one like that. Bam! The breast grow immediately and the hand was separated. Thanksgiving. Now, let me end by telling you this. I want you to receive a little impartation this afternoon. A little impartation. Now, hear me. There are people you must meet for your life to change. Let me go to the people here after the preaching the message. I say there are people you must meet for your life to change.
Yes, sir.
And there are places you must be for your life to change.
Yes, sir.
Today, may you encounter both of them. Yes, are you getting it? There are people you must meet for your life to change.
Yes, sir.
And there are places you must be for your life to change.
Yes, sir.
After this fasting, may you find yourself in all these two places.
Amen.
There are people you must meet. And there are places you must be.
Now hear me, boy.
There are spiritual factories that must remodel your destiny. Did you hear what I just said? The way you go to Interplast and they are molding polytanks and things. There are spiritual factories, and I commit to you that this place is one of the spiritual factories. I got this word from God today. I got it from the Lord today. He said, I have 10 potters to be, Potter City to be a spiritual factory. And I am going to remold people's lives and destiny. There are places you must be for your life to change. There are people you must meet for your life to change. And there are spiritual factories that remold your life. Change your destiny. What do you mean by there are people you must meet? Saul was miserably looking for his father's axe until he met Samuel. He met the prophet Samuel. The prophetic helping, and he encountered it. So there are people you must meet. Until you meet them, your destiny cannot change. And there are places you must be for your destiny to change. Hey, man of God, if Ruth stayed in Moab, his life wouldn't have changed. May the Lord relocate you to where he has ordained for you. I can close with this. You are not standing on an ordinary ground. This ground is a supernatural ground. God has chosen to put his name on this place. God's name is here. There are places you must be, and the places are spiritual factory that remold your life. If you don't walk in that revelation, you come to Potter's and take it for granted. Lord, how do you do this? Is it true that there are no debt on this? Is it true that you built this in 3 years? The next 3 years, Lord, make my life a household. Because you know you are in a spiritual factory. Getting what I'm talking about? That is what it is. I will teach you the full counsel of God. Is somebody hearing me? I told you yesterday, all grounds are not the same. All grounds are not the same. There are certain ground people, my God say, remove your sandals. When you are standing, it's a holy ground. It's not the same. So it's not every ground you go, you become familiar with the ground. Because that ground is a spiritual factory. What do I call it? Spiritual factory. It can remold your life. It can, this lanyard speakers, these metals, monitors, they will know the way it is. They were coming from a factory. The factory has the power to imagine and create the beauty of it. So there are spiritual factory like that, man of God, that when you enter with battered life, it changes you to be something that everybody can celebrate. And that is what God is going to do this evening. Spiritual factory. Remolding.
Yes, Lord.
My life wouldn't have been. That is why God brings different people into your life. Different people into your life. Lord, this evening, this afternoon, remold my life. How did that arrive here? Your revelation is what to put you on top. That's all. Spiritual factories. Amen. I went to South Korea. I came with the sand from there. I went to Kenya and I came with the sand from there. I went to Redeem Christian. I came with the sand from there. Bishop T.D. Jakes' ground and Dallas, I came with the sand. So when I... No. Naaman said, I will not worship that foolish God in Syria again. He carries sand from Jerusalem. He said, I will put it on my ground and stand on it. When I'm standing in that soil in my house, I'm standing in Jerusalem. Revelation, revelation, revelation. The spirit of revelation. May the Lord cause you to locate your spiritual place. There are people you must meet. Give me 1 Samuel chapter 10 from verse number 1. On the day of securing and shutting the devil from counter reaction, I will teach you 4 levels of tongues. Amen.
Jesus is Lord. I say Jesus is Lord. May you be delivered from shallow Christianity. Debt, 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 debt. Deep call it for deep. Debt, 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 debt. If you take root downwards, you bear fruit upwards. Debt, debt. God is so big. Only shallow men think they have enough of him. In the kingdom, you don't arrive. You only make progress. You don't arrive. Because God is too big for you to arrive at his territory. You only make progress. You don't arrive. You only make progress. Some people thought they have arrived. That's why they've plateaued. Don't arrive. Don't arrive. Your complaint is what has locked your heavens straight. And Lord, look at me. Look at me. My back and my hips. Why is it I don't have a husband? Who give you the hips? You can't intimidate him with your age. He's a rock of ages. Now listen, is it not because of your fasting you are coming to threaten him? Look at the way I fasted for 40 days. Have you heard God has eaten before? Chapter 9 somewhere. Huh? Now there was a man of Benjamin whose name was Kish, Saul's father, and the son of Abiel, the son of Zeror, the son of what? Bekorath, and the son of Apia. He looked like Apia, but this one is Afia. Huh? A Benjamin, a mighty man of power. Go to the next verse. And he had a son whose name was Saul, a choice young man and godly. The godly does not mean that. The goodly, goodly means that. Well, Saul more of a kakra. Hallelujah. And there was not among the children of Israel a godlier person than he. From his shoulder and upward, he was higher than anybody. Now, give me the NIV version on this one. Let me show you something. He had a son named Saul, impressive young man, without equal among the Israelites, a head taller than any of the others. It counts. No wonder women like tall men. Go to the next verse. Now the donkeys belonging to Saul's father Kish were lost, and Kish said to his son Saul, now hear me. This shows where you come from. There are certain animals, when they get missing and we are going to look for them, it shows the state of your poverty. It is just showing where you come from. Donkeys, when they get missing at that time, they are even considered unclean animals. You don't go and look for them. But when you are poor, you will find a rat. Hear me, I'm preaching. I say there are people you must meet. That is the first point for your destiny to change. Now watch this. There are people you must meet. Take one of the servants with you and go and look for the donkeys. Go to the next verse. Huh? And so he passed through the hill country of Ephraim and through the area around, but did not find them. They went on onto the district of Shalim, but the donkeys were not there. They were going through all over Accra, then passed through the territory of Benjamin, but they did not find them. Where are you, donkeys? When they reached the district of Zoph, Saul said to his servant, who is with him, come, let us go back. Or my father will stop thinking about the donkeys and start worrying about us. But the servant replied, look, in this town, there is a man of God. He is highly respected, and everything he says comes true. Let us go there now. Perhaps he will tell us where to take. May the Lord reveal things to us in this meeting. Open it up.
Amen.
Have you thought about the deliverances God has given to you people throughout this fasting? Have you thought about the revelation that has come? Have you thought about the signboard of towns that are going there with 7 horses and 7 cows that God has revealed? You will not be exempted from the deliverance list. Your army is a Ghanaian army. I need a Nigerian army. Saul said to his servant, if we go, what can we give the man? The food in our sack is gone. We have not give to take to the man of God. What do we have? It means that those days, they don't go to men of God with an empty hand, and particularly prophet. You are the only one who does that.
He even want to come and collect what you have. The servant answered him, look, he said, I have a quarter of shekel of silver. I will give to the man of God so that he will tell us what way to take. God is orchestrating something. I say there are people you must meet. You will not be searching for Acts 6 again. Formerly in Israel, if a man went to inquire of God, he would say, come and let us go to the seer. Because the prophet today used to be called what? Seers. So it was started from seer and it became the prophet. A seer is the one that sees into the spirit. And so those days, when they go to the prophet, they go and they call them seer. Now go to the next verse. Don't let me waste time. Good. Saul said to his servant, come, let us go. So they set out for the town where the man of God was. And what happened? As they were going up the hill to the town, they met some girls. I'm sure they were potter's girls coming out to draw water. And they asked them, is the seer here? Potter said, no. I like that one. He said, they answered, he is ahead of you. Hurry now. He's just come to our town today. For the people have sacrificed at the high places. May you join those who are sacrificing at the high places. Yesterday, God told me something. The prophetic anointing you honor will grow on your life. It will just service you. The oil you honor will move on your direction. It's as simple as that. These people have honored the prophet before they want to see him. Number one, they don't want to go and see him empty-handed. Number two, they want to go with honor and respect. Amen. They were inquiring to find out where he was. Not people who sit down and gossip about prophets. Can't get anything. Somebody say, amen. As soon as you enter the town, you will find him before he goes up to the high places to eat. Today, people don't understand why God blesses a servant. Somewhere, them were eating at high places. They don't eat at Choba. High places. Do you know a high place? People are angry when they see men of God bless.
Yes.
Should we preach and sit on a horse? Can you imagine that when you are coming driving your Mercedes, I'm sitting on a horse coming from motorway? Crazy. That's my prophet. As soon as you enter to the town, you will find him before he goes to the high place to eat. The people will not begin eating until he comes. What an honor for the prophet. Somebody will be blessed today.
Yeah.
The people will not eat until he comes. Because he must bless the sacrifice. After those who are invited will eat. Go up now. You should find him about this time. The potter's girl will give you all the history. And tell you what you must do. That's why I say marry them. They went up to the town. As they were entering, there was Samuel coming toward them on his way up to the high places. Wow. May you find your prophet.
Amen.
Now, the day before Saul came, the Lord had revealed this to Samuel. The day before Saul came, the Lord has revealed, God has revealed to me that you'll be a millionaire. I have been telling you. I say, God told me, how many times have I said this in this meeting? You don't believe it. God has told me that you'll be a household name.
Amen.
God has told me you'll be the envy of your father's
Amen.
House. You will be the envy of your mother's house.
Amen.
Ghana will celebrate you.
Amen.
As America is celebrating Bill Gates. Somebody say, on what authority do you say that? How can a man who doesn't have trotter money, after about 70, 80 years, God can use him to build a city? So 70 years from now, do you know what your life will be like? Those who didn't say, they don't know what I'm talking about. I used to go there without a city. Impartation. Anointing can be transferred. Anointing can be imparted. Anything that grow can be transferred. Get hungry. I say get hungry for the oil. Be hungry for the anointing. You cannot be anointed and be frustrated.
after this fasting, things are going to happen. Things are going to happen. Things are going to happen. Realms of impartation.
Realms
of transformation. There shall be a performance.
There
shall be a performance. Blessed is he that believeth. There shall be a performance. About this time tomorrow, I will send you a man from the land of Benjamin. Anoint him a leader over my people of Portes. He will deliver my people from the hands of the Philistines. I have looked upon my people, for their cry has reached me. Listen, the Lord say, anoint these people. Let them go out and storm the world. Anoint them to be multi-millionaires in the nation.
Amen.
Go to the next verse. Watch this. Kasusasaya. When Samuel caught sight of Saul, the Lord said unto him, this is the man. Look at someone and say, you are the man or you are the woman.
You the woman. You are the man.
You are the one God is looking for. You the man. You the man. Tell the person, you the man.
You the
woman. You are the man. You are the woman. This is the man. And this is the place. This is the man. You are the one. You are not here by accident. You didn't come here. God brought you here. I saw you didn't come here. God brought you here. You are not hearing me this prophetic this afternoon for accident. You are not hearing this prophetic voice by accident. The grace that is building Potter City. Receive 7 times that grace on your head. Do you believe it at all? Do you know what it means to carry 7 times the grace on Potter City? Unusual grace. Tell somebody you are the man. You are the woman. Tell them.
You are the man.
Tell them. You are the man. God is saying you are the man. This is the man I spoke to you about. He will govern my people. You will govern Africa. You will govern your father's house.
Amen.
You will govern the nation of God.
Amen.
You will take dominion in your
environment. Amen.
Hear this. Saul approached Samuel in the gateway and asked, will you please tell me where the seer's house is? He is talking to his messenger prophet.
Jesus.
Sit down. He has met his helper. I am the seer. Or say, come to the previous verse. Huh? Will you please tell me where the seer is? Where do you leave this room? Eh? The person you are asking question will be the one that God is sending you to. Oh, somebody didn't catch what I'm saying. Your messenger prophet. From now, Saul is going to ride on prophetic wings.
Yes.
Prophetic helping hand. Kazavasu sisis. Rezavazia. Batistu Ramakita Kasu. Matinama Anima Tokasai. Now watch it. And look at what he said. Tell me where the seer's house is. I am the seer.
Ha.
And Samuel replied, go ahead of me to the high place. For today, you are to eat with me. May the Lord change your dining hall table. May the Lord change your eating place. May the Lord change your sleeping place. May the Lord change the company. This man is going to the high places. This man is miserably looking for his father's access. In just 1 second, God said, you are the man. And your destiny is changing. Suddenly, somebody's destiny is about to change.
Suddenly.
Do you remember the point? There are people you must meet. There are people you must meet. Somewhere, Saul has met the one he's supposed to meet. Never be the same. Never be the same. I'm telling you, God will bring different people into your life. Give me the scripture. For today, you are to eat with me in the morning. You are to eat with me, and in the morning, I will let you go. It means that he's going to sleep in Samuel's guest room. And I will tell you all that is in your heart.
Powerful. 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 There are people you must meet. See that number two. There are places you must be. There are places. Not every place. You are not supposed to be at every place, but there are places you must be. Somebody after this meeting. Kaduma Shatakapa. I said there are places you must be. Not everywhere. There are places. There are places. There are places. There's a place you go, your story will change for good. Ruth chapter 2. There are places you must be. Ruth. And Naomi has a relative on her husband's side. From, you see, I love what this lady said. I will not leave you from today. Your people shall be my people. Your God shall be my God. I am renouncing the God of Moab. And I'm taking a new God. Today, before we finish the fasting, may you renounce something from your background.
Amen.
He renounced. When he said, your people shall be my people, and your God shall be my God, he literally renounced the God of Moab and joined himself to the God of Israel. And that is what brought him this. Now listen, when he followed his mother-in-law, the mother-in-law said, I'm not going to give birth to other sons for you to marry them. Stay there. Orpah decided to go back to the God of Moab. Nobody heard about him again. Naomi decided to join the God of Jerusalem. Your people shall be my people. That is why the Christian family is very crucial. Sometimes when you check your family is too rough, renounce it and come and join the Christian family. Stay among the Christian family. Find a family in the church and connect yourself to them. Are you getting what I'm talking about? Because God has two families. I bow my knees down to the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, of whom the whole family of heaven and earth is named. So there's a family of God in heaven and there's a family of God on earth. He renounced and came back to the land of Jerusalem. Now, Naomi had a relative on her husband's side from the clan of Elimelech, and a man of Elimelech, a man of standing whose name was Boaz. Give me the New Living Translation. Let me see the way he talks about the man of standing. Now, there was a wealthy and influential man in Bethlehem named Boaz, who was a relative of Naomi's husband, Elimelech. Are you getting it? There was what? A wealthy and influential man. After this fasting, may you meet wealthy.
Amen.
I'm not trying to mean any disrespect, anything, but I want to tell you that Unamfunyina are broke. I'm not talking to everybody but you. It's time for some very good people to come into it. Because the problem is working around broke people is that they won't let you rise up. Until your company change, your pocket will never change. No. 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 Sometimes God has to literally change the group of people. So leave them behind. Kofobia, I know I'm not going to go and because they will kill you. They will fight you. They will kill you. Hallelujah. And let me tell you something about the top. The top is very lonely. When you begin to climb to the top, there are certain friends automatically they will leave your life. Amen. And I can't there. There are some friends you don't have them again. They can't become your friend. It won't be possible. When you are going up, you must drop them. I used to have some friends. They are not my friends again. I didn't sack them, but they can't handle where I'm going. Some people are part of your history, but they're not part of your destination. Give the Lord a clap of it. I'm preaching. And sometimes where you are moving in, you must be careful to choose friends. Careful. I'm trying to hang around people who have gone where I've never been. All your friends, you are ahead of them. None of your friends have traveled. None of somebody was going to Togo. He was refused entry. Togo. Ade. You are going to Togo and you are refused entry. When he told me, I told him, I said, listen, you don't need deliverance, you need crusade. No deliverance can help you. For you to refuse Togo, where will you go after Togo? They have refused to entry. He said he was a flower, but the man said, no, you can't enter Togo. It's a serious matter. Where will you go from there? Refusing entry from Ghana to Togo. Jesus Christ. Can we take you to Amsterdam? I break every limitation on your life.
I break it completely. You better shout amen for God to deliver you. Friends, all your friends are driving Tiggo. So your Toyota RAV4, you say you are a king. If you don't meet some people, you'll be complete sense. Sit down. No, I couldn't be. After I went to South Korea, and I went to Kenala, and I went to Dr. Copeland's place, and I went to Redeem, I couldn't come and build auditorium. So I was standing in those compounds, something entered me. One of the most serious statements Jesus made is that somebody broke an expensive ointment, perfume, Quran on his feet. It paid Judas so much because Judas said, how can we don't break perfume, we spray it. Jesus said, leave them alone, leave them alone. The poor will always be with you. It means that you choose to be poor. It's a choice. I've said before, you life and death, blessing and cursing, choose life. Prosperity is a choice. Poverty is a choice. Money is part of prosperity. Money is not prosperity. It's part of it. Prosperity is the state of the mind. It's as simple as that. I can't change your pocket until I change your mind. I can't. Africa, until we change our mind, our pocket will not change. There are places you must go for your life to change. May you locate that place now. Africa, we don't have a problem. Oh, Ghana, we don't have a problem. We have bauxite. We have manganese. Do we have manganese? Do we have diamond? We have gold. We have oil. I hear we have gas now. Oh, any problem? I can't attitude. If this group alone change, it can affect the whole nation. Remnant of people. There are places you must go for your life to change. Well, if you're straight, you know, I was a cocoa no pa, red, we are cocoa, ten you marry, it was so sad. No entertainment, no nothing. No, no. There are spiritual factories that remold your life. What did I say? Spiritual what? You see the things I'm preaching now? I am remolding people's life, changing your mindset. Once I change your mindset, I've changed your destiny. Give the Lord a clap of. If you don't think of it, anointing, jia. So we are anointing people whose mindset have not changed. It has never changed. When we anoint people, they are not mindset changed. They grow in the spirit. And they are not knowledgeable. And it's very sad to see spiritual people who are not knowledgeable. They make others who don't believe in spirituality insult spirituality. Tap somebody and say, grow, grow. Tap somebody and say, grow, grow. When the Lord shall build up Zion, he will appear in his glory. So God's greatest desire is to build you up. Once you are built, the glory is automatic. Amen. Spiritual. Let me read the root and close. Now, there was a wealthy and influential man in Bethlehem named Boaz, who was a relative of Naomi's husband, Elimelech. One day, Ruth the Moabite said unto Naomi, let me go out unto the harvest field to pick up the stock of the grain left behind by anyone who is kind enough to let me do it. Naomi replied, all right, my daughter, go ahead. So he's going to go and find some menial job and do, because he's a bro, not really like a labor in the field. He's not thinking, just go there, labor. One day they pay you 50, you go back, and let me find favor that somebody will help me do that. And he go there. God, there are places you must be for your destiny to change. And after this fasting, may you find yourself in those places. Being there right place at the right time. And meeting the right person at the right spot. Change your life. Watch this. Feel baby. So Ruth went to gather grain behind the harvesters. And as it happened, she found herself working in a field that belonged to Boaz. Now let me show you what happened. It was like farms, eh? But it's not Boaz alone that have the farm there. So this particular farm belonged to Mr. Shokwanda. This one belonged to Boaz. This one belonged to Mr. Shenene. And this one belonged to Mr. Bosca. Now, luckily, when he went there, for some reason, He fired himself. If Ruth were to work in Brother Shukwanda's farm, she will make a breakthrough. You are not getting. Read the scripture again. So when you drive to the where they plant the rice, I don't know the name, Aveime rice there. People have different farms over there. So when you go there, you can particularly go to a certain farm that belongs to Pastor Abed, but it might not necessarily that it's for Dixon. So look at the way the Bible put it. So Ruth went to gather the grain behind the harvesters. Now, the harvesters, let me tell you something about the harvesters. The harvesters are there gathering the grain. They just put them there to do the work. You hire them, and they have 100 harvesting because all the farms are on the same line. When they harvest, whatever they harvest, they put it at the end. It's for boas. Some of the harvesters are harvesting here for Brother Shukwanda. And this. So you can't even tell who they are working, but they are working for different people. When Ruth got there, the Bible said he started. So Ruth went out together to gather grain behind the harvesters. So he was gathering the grain. As they are harvesting the thing, whatever they cut, then there are people that pack them. They are packing and loading them and binding them so that they will take them to the machine for graining. And Ruth found himself, and as it happened, she find herself working in a field that belonged to Boaz. There is a place you must be for your destiny to change. No. I said there is a place you must be for your destiny to change.
Amen.
Now, Osofo, it was the same job. You might have been paid the same way. But if you went to another harvest or another person's farm, you wouldn't have gotten the breakthrough. So it's not a matter of working in a bank. There is a particular bank you must work to locate a particular customer.
Yes.
Oh, man. May you be at the right place at the right time. May you find, I see there is a place you can be for your life to change.
Amen.
I am prophesying to somebody. Professor. I am prophesying to somebody.
Professor.
I am prophesying to somebody.
Professor.
I am prophesying to somebody.
Yes.
The devil cannot interrupt it.
Amen.
So there is a place you must be for your life to change.
Ah.
There is a place you must be for your life to change.
Yes.
Because if you are not at that place, the right person will not locate you. She find herself harvesting at Boaz. Now, watch this. I want to show you something. It happened. She find herself working in the field that belonged to Boaz, the relative of the father-in-law, Elimelech. Ebusia connection. Now, watch this. I want you to notice something. While she was there, Boaz arrived. No, you're shouting. I'm closing because I wish I can preach this in Nigeria. That's all. No, after the fasting, may you be where your helper will just arrive. Whilst he was there, man of God, Boaz arrived. The owner of this man, according to Bible history, was the richest man in his time. This is the Bill Gates of his time. This is the Rockefeller of his time. This man is the Bloomberg of his time. Heavy loaded. And the Bible says he arrived. Hey, what will move you from being a labor to a first lady?
Hey.
There is a place you must be for your life to change. Will you permit me to pray a prayer for you this afternoon? Will you permit me to prophesy over your life this afternoon? Will you permit me to release something over your life? Man of God, there is a place you must be to meet a helper.
Hey.
That will put money in your hand.
Amen.
There is a man of God called Robert Kayanja. Powerful man of God. He was building a glass building. His story was very interesting. Went to America and there was a woman who was a multimillionaire sick. And he went to visit that time. Paul Crutch loved him a lot. And he went to pray for the woman. And for some reason, he happened to be at the right place at the right time. He was passing. He said, let's go and greet Dr. Paul Crutch. When he greeted them, then there was this woman. He said, oh, I'm going to pray for somebody. Yeah, Kayanda, follow me. When he went there, he said, you have a healing anointing. Lay hands on the woman and God healed the woman.
Oh!
What do you want me to do? And the woman wrote a check. Millions. Bam. Wrote it.
Do you remember the pastor who gave testimony at South Korea that they gave him $5 million? He was just at the golf field at the right time. There is a place you must be for your story to change. There is a place you must be for your destiny to change. I declare after this 40 days fasting, today is the last, but tomorrow by this time, may the Lord order your steps to that place.
Amen.
He happened to be at the field. Well, and while she was there, Boaz arrived from Bethlehem and greeted the harvesters. Watch this. Right? Boaz could have come from the back. Boaz could have come from somewhere. Nobody knows. So the girl was standing at a place where Boaz normally passed. She herself didn't know. The owner of the field, the richest man in the town, has come. You can also be somewhere. You could have been in front of the harvesters. The man will not see him. He was behind the harvesters. Supernatural and divine position. Watch this. Huh? And greeted the harvesters. The Lord be with you. And he said, the Lord bless you. The harvesters replied. Now watch this. So man of God, the harvesters are in front. Ruth was behind them. Boaz is now talking to the harvesters. And the harvesters say that, hey, the Lord bless you. They are the most important people. He came to check whether they are harvesting the maize. Look at the nervous. Look at what happened. And whilst he was talking to them, the Boaz asked his foreman, the man in charge of the field, who is this young woman over there? Oh, man.
Hey!
Somebody that's not understand what I'm talking about. Does it look like you? Does it look like you? Does it look like you? There is a place you must be for your destiny to change. There is a place you must be for your story to change. There is a place. Whilst he was talking to the harvesters, and his eye was scanning among all the ladies harvesting there, his eye hit a queer Guatemala
bay.
And he said, Kadima Sotaya. Then Boaz asks his foreman, because when they come to the field, not everybody can hang around there. Yeah. Where was Boaz going that he passed there? Oh, Lord, who is this message for?
For me.
Lord, who am I preaching to?
Yeah.
Then Boaz asks his foreman. So he's asking the man in charge, who is that young woman over there? Who does he belong to? And the foreman replied, she's a young woman from Moab, what kind of background, who came back with Naomi. She asked me this morning if you could gather grain behind the harvesters. She has been hard at work ever since. Except for a few minutes rest in the shelter, she's always working. So the man has described her that he's a virtuous woman. Obey Juma. Che, mami from Mount. Now where you're there. Obey Juma, and you're near him. Uncle Jabba, be in your makeup. Uncle Kana, no. Uncle Boo, chess. She's gathering grain. Uncle Jina, a piece and call for toilet. No, 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 trip. But say, Binum, one tomba, sorry, I'm just a Sunday man. I said, no, I call. I saw Kodjusa Kodjina. Ruth is on the field. Listen to that. She asked me this morning if she could gather grain behind. It is his first time in the field. It doesn't take you 1 year to get your breakthrough. First day on the field. First time on the field. Working very hard. They have his testimony. She has been hard at work ever since, except for a few minutes rest in the shelter. So you can't story at Boaz. Let's hear what the richest man at that time would say. Boaz went over and said to Ruth, listen, my daughter, stay right here with us. When you gather grain, don't go to any other fields.
Hey!
Apostle, I wish everybody say, hey, the way you are saying, something has entered. Somebody say, hey! Look at somebody say, stay here. Tell somebody, stay here. Stay. Stay at Portes. And come, baby. Stay at Portes. Don't go and climb the bed. Stay at Portes. The God of Prophet Anna said, I will remember you. Traha. Traha. The God who brought to me, you will remember you. Traha. It may delay, but it cannot be denied. And by what tired energy? A contrary tired energy. Stay here. Yeah? Listen, we're your foreman and your castle. And your harvesters. The oga kwata kwata. You can't fire her again. The foreman has no power over her again. The owner says stay. Who is the foreman to say go? If you threaten Ruth, your life is at stake. You can lose your job. I call it the days of harvest of the fasting. Man gonna break. May you take a container and gather as many. By the time it gets to your house, it will be gold. It will be gold. It will not be mangoes. It will be gold. Boaz went over and said to Ruth, listen, my daughter, stay right here with us. When you gather grain, don't go to any other field. Stay right here behind the young woman. And come be a man or no. Working in the field. Stay behind the young woman. And call me man. It'll be a bad boy. Because Boaz. Jacob told Ruby, you went to my coach. Jenny up a petty naudi. Crab bunny. Emra, all bless us. Jira! You are the beginning of my strength, the excellence of dignity. Tell somebody, stay away from your father's prop. Stay away. Now give it to me. See which part of the field they are harvesting. And then follow them. I have warned the young men not to treat you roughly. Divine immunity.
Yes, sir.
I said this one is filled immunity. The Bible says, Umbra, young man, when you're Umbra. If you never call, so I'll let you wait. You have fun and sanka.
Yes, sir.
Muna munch.
Yes, sir.
Martin Amicharon.
Yes, sir.
Because all Saka will pay.
Yes, sir.
Because all Saka will pay. So I'll get you. You have fun and sanka.
Yes, sir.
Now, you'll be on this. I'll be coming. I can't tell me.
Give the Lord a song.
This is the first time Boaz is warning people on the field. Are you rumor? Na Kevin, Baba, are you my warning, sir? The anointing is for unlikely. The anointing is for the unlikely.
Hey!
The anointing is for the unlikely.
Hey!
The favor is for the unlikely.
Hey!
The honor is for the unlikely.
Hey!
The stone that the builders rejected. Give the Lord a shout.
Yeah!
Oh, this is for somebody here. This is for somebody here. I am prophesying and preaching at the same time.
Professor.
The anointing is for the unlikely. People that nobody, God takes the foolish things of this world and he uses it to confound the wise. And was saying, I have warned the young men not to treat you roughly. And when you are thirsty, help yourself to the water they have drawn from the well.
Hey!
Dear, Ruth fell at his feet and thanked him warmly. Oh, thanksgiving. What have I done to deserve such a kindness? She asks, I am only a foreigner. I can hear you say the same thing to your helper. Who is me? After this fasting, Yamidi will deem back. Yes, I know.
Go to verse 10. What do I do to deserve such kindness? She asks. I am only a foreigner. Listen to Boaz. Yes, I know. Boaz replied. But I also know about everything you have done for your mother-in-law. Your good deeds will be remembered. Since the death of your husband, I have heard how you left your father and mother and your own land to live here among complete strangers. May the Lord, the God of Israel, under whose wings you have come to take refuge, reward you fully for what you have done. Amen. And I am the one God who used to reward you. That's what the man is saying. So if you do know something, Boaz is not just a rich man. He's a God-fearing man and a prophet. He released a prophetic word over the land immediately and assured her of a reward for the sacrifice he has made. Right? There is a reward to every sacrifice. There is a reward.
Amen.
I hope I continue to please you, sir. Hey, this girl is smart. Moab girl. She replied, you have comforted me by speaking so kindly to me. Even I am not one of your workers. It means that I am not a fully employed worker. I am not qualified. I'm just a laborer. We are a casual worker. It will be permanent at any time. It's not one of the people that they are paying a social security. Listen. At mealtime, Boaz called her. At mealtime, Boaz called her. Come over here and help yourself to some food. Hey! You can dip your bread in the salt wine. So she sat with his harvesters, and Boaz gave her some roasted grain to eat. She ate all she wanted and still had some left over. Miss anyone? When Ruth went back to work again, Boaz ordered this young man, let her gather grain right among the sheaves without stopping her. And pull out some heads of barley from the bundles and drop them on purpose for her. Let her pick them up and don't give her a hard time. Second one, Imumraha. This one, all of you lift your hands. When she comes here, move far, then remove the grains and don't give her a hard time. Anything I come to hear, you are all fired. Do you hear?
Yes, sir.
Do you hear? Do you hear what I said?
Dismiss.
The Lord is telling me right now that the story you are reading, that is how somebody's story is going to be.
Amen.
And the person will remember what you were seeing.
Oh, Jesus.
The Lord just told me, rather than make us say. And you're preaching, you are not preaching, you are prophesying to you will notice your life go like this. And pull out. So Ruth gathered berry there all day. And when she beat out the grain that evening, it filled an entire basket. She carried it back into town and showed it to her mother-in-law. Ruth also gave her the roasted grain that was left over for her meal. The girl is a good girl. She remembered her mother-in-law.
Yeah.
She didn't eat what was possible. Or kind of mother-in-law. She's a good girl. May the Lord give you a good woman to marry.
Yeah.
Where did you gather all this grain today? Naomi asks. Where did you work? May the Lord bless the one who helped you. So Ruth told her mother-in-law about the man in whose field she has worked. She said, the man I work with today is named Boaz. Hey, remember, Ruth's mentor is Naomi. May the Lord bless him. Naomi told her daughter-in-law, he is showing his kindness to us as well as to your dead husband. That man is one of our closest relatives, one of our family redeemers. May you meet your redeemer after his fasting. Go there. I just reading the scripture is a blessing. The Ruth said, what is more,
Boaz even told me to come back and stay with his harvesters until the entire harvest is completed. They're making it overcharge. Good. Naomi exclaimed, do as he said, my daughter. Stay with his young woman right through the whole harvest. You might be harassed in other fields, but you will be safe with him. May you not go where you will be harassed. May you go. Bishop, there is a place for us to be for our destiny to change. And when you find that place, you will not be harassed. The harassment is too much. So Rook work alongside the woman in Boaz field and gather grain with them until the end of the berry harvest. I'm taking you somewhere. Then she continued working with them through the wheat harvest, early summer, and all while she lived with her mother-in-law. One day, Naomi said to Ruth, my daughter, it is time that I found a permanent home for you so that you will be provided for. And come say, the lesson. Boaz is a close relative of ours, and he has been very kind by letting you gather grain with his young woman. Tonight, he will be winnowing barley at the threshing floor. Give me the new... No, stay there. Stay there. Give me the Message Bible. Isn't Boaz our close relative? And one whose young woman you have been working? Maybe it is time to make our move. Hey. Dallas.
Abrewana sensi bibi. No. There is something experience can do. Hey, catch your business. Dallas. Dallas.
Now, this one is experience. Fatu wana miche. We have to make a move. Tonight is the night of Boaz berry harvest at the threshing floor. A special night, a special harvest. I hear you. Mamina senses a move is coming. Come back to the New Living Translation. Now, do as I tell you. Take a bath. Hey!
I want everybody to take a step and walk like this. You receive the spirit of contagious when God blesses you with money.
Are you understanding what I'm talking about?
Look at somebody's experience. Experience.
Experience.
Tell somebody counseling.
Counseling.
And tell somebody dalesin.
Dalesin.
Now do as I tell you. Me mouth dalesin. Boy, take a bath and put a perfume.
Perfume.
And dress in your nicest clothes. Then go to the threshing floor. But don't let Boaz see you until he has finished eating and drinking.
Dalesin. Katuna said, Dalesin.
Missy Tiamunaka said, Dalesin.
Dalesin.
We end up your wine. A move slow. Experience Naomi. Be sure to notice where he lies down and go uncover his feet and lie down there. He will tell you what to do.
I feel like trotting. I feel like somebody is trotting to his destiny. Somebody is trotting to his breakthrough.
Give the Lord a shout.
Look at the woman. I will do everything you say, Ruth replied. Whatever he tells you to do, do it. So she went down to the threshing floor that night and followed the instructions of her mother-in-law. Whoa! I saw my making a wunchi. This girl received dalesin. And follow the instructions of the Dallas.
Them.
Where your friend Pasco? Pasco. Pasco, I say. Pasco. Pasco, no, you're repeating Pasco. Them.
This is Pasco. counseling. The road you are passing, people have passed there before.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
After Boaz has finished eating and drinking and was in good spirits, he lay down at the far end of the pile of the grain and went to sleep. And Ruth came quietly, uncovered his feet and lay down. That lesson. Around midnight.
Hey. Somebody say, Kazduyas.
Kazduyas. Boaz suddenly woke up and turned over. She was surprised to find a woman lying at his feet. That lesson. Midnight prayer. And I jump by ball. And I'm by your boy. And I'm even me crying.
Amen.
Who are you? He asked. I am your servant, Ruth. She replied. Spread the corner of your uncovering over me, for you are my family redeemer. The Lord bless you, my daughter, Boaz exclaimed. You are showing even more family loyalty now than you did before. For you have not gone after young man, whether rich or poor. Now don't worry about a thing, my daughter. I will do what is necessary. For everyone in town knows you are a virtuous woman.
Hey,
this is the secret. Character, the security of every great destiny. Subai, a kawano call who subai. Why shall the Bible fall? Every. Everybody in town knows. So when she married the richest man, nobody was surprised. His background couldn't even disqualify him. His character buried the background. Rumor. Everybody in Porter City knows her. Umuadi. Importance in a ubunkunya. Onantia crutch, I say, Umwadi. Where you walk. When you go and come, you are writing your testimony. People are watching. It's a heavy duty statement. Everybody know in time. Are you a virtuous woman? God will not put it in his way if this is a lie. Obia nim say you don't respect your husband. Umwa dia menya kopon fere so beka wase. Rush. Close. One day somebody must recommend you. One day. Somebody say, ah! Mr. Pharaoh, I've remembered there is a young man in prison. He's a godly guy. He said, go and bring him. Joseph must come to the palace, but the butler must recommend. Can somebody recommend you? Beauty is vain, but a woman that fears the Lord. We are not talking about makeups. Big back, big hips. There is a time in your life a man don't need that. She needs a woman that will counsel.
Christopher, youngest Abba. Ni so dear. What for Bishop Fompa? So, who is a pastor? Now, who Bishop Fompa? Reverend, who is he? One, GSS girl tell his pastor, his teacher, all of a sudden you're a small girl, ask headmaster. So you don't have a stand. Levels are in the thing. We say I'm a small boy, ask the headmaster. It's mom, yeah, you were the near transfer. Also, for my share, everybody knows in town. What does people know about two importers? Excuse me. Boy, you better catch up. We are not free. The crown of his head to the soles of his feet. A lady addressed a guy here. He forgotten that he has a car. He walked to the gate. The security people, it's your car, boy. He said, oh, yeah, I'm sorry. Before he remembered to come and take his car. It's a serious matter. And then I still finding the guy to ask, what did he tell you? He forgotten his car, small car. Walked to the gate before the security said, ah, sir, your car is for. He said, oh, okay, okay. Then he said, ah, man, car. See, daddy told me, useless guy. Am I your type? And he said, he was talking, crying. Oh, Lord, what have I done? That these guys are coming to tell me, they're like, Jesus Christ. Can you refill in a car? Look at this guy I put here that they say is a short guy. Short. Character. Boaz has the same height. Anymore. 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 It is dangerous for us to be caught up by the excitement. Now we don't talk about what sustained this one. The kind of wealth I have, the kind of house I built, the nature of my business, I can't just marry anybody. Everybody knows in town. You are a virtuous woman. So me wadewa, nobody will question it. Bishop, this is it. We can't deceive, we have to tell you the truth. There are young men ready to marry. They need women with character. If they bring you to the house, what would you do to this guy? A day now, Bayeno. Now, you cross off on your own child. Send a tear. What would be your story if you find yourself like this? Okay? Some people, their beauty has taken them to marriage, character has brought them out. You can prepare for wedding and not prepare for marriage. It's as simple as that. Now, see, what's up? First scripture and the two. Famicom message Bible. And now, my dear daughter, don't you worry about a thing. I will do all you could want or ask. Everybody in town know what a courageous woman you are. A rare prize. Bishop, in terms of your warrior, what a dear a sumbo. I mean, value for money. How do you become like this? Go and study the book of Ruth. I hear them now we see. I know church. In the afori gome ya odia shoot it. See no. Who shoot it the yakob? Yeah. Excuse me.
Hello.
Do you know what's on?
Oh dear.
Answer me. This one is it for you. What they are doing for spirituality, but that's not where the solution is. Nobody marries spirit.
No.
I'm a man. I am a man. You don't marry spirit. So it does not mean you are going to get a husband to marry. No. Make sure it is backed by character. And for your information with your bad clapping, character is not a gift, it is developed. About it. And the question is, who should buy? Can a rich man say that everybody knows in town? Can I recommend you? Do you know what the pastors we do? Sometimes when we don't want to commit ourselves, we tell the people, please go and pray. Obana Makacho say go and pray. It's the same P. What the yahoo.com can is an email address. I told you, I have a friend, pastor, in America, when I went there, give me your email address. He said, insempi@yahoo.com. I went there, I saw some message, and also I was some email address. Also for there, I was saying, the next one here, @yahoo.com. Find it. Two email address. The whom spell small hmmm6@yahoo.com. Who send it? And then, insempi. Also for, if we jump and we go home and let people go thinking that they are going to go to a field and we don't add this one, we have deceived them. What's up? We have deceived them. We have deceived them completely. I was waiting for this point. This is the point I'm waiting for. Everybody knows in town. What happened after? Come back to New Living. What happened after everybody knows in town? Bank kakra oye juma. Loan kakra e diaman. Siuta wo shedi hangi kaechi. I have gone to bank and the way some of the ladies can be disrespectful in the cage as if the money is for them. Forgotten that you are working because of my money. Disrespect. You don't even know the person you are talking to. You don't know. You don't have to know people before you respect them.
Yes, of course.
Apostle Peter, they may be angels. Yes. Entertain visitors as you do that. They may be angels. Everybody knows in town. So everything has an opposite. Everybody knows in town. Why you kuama? He has lost his equilibrium. He's confused. You have insulted the guy. All his self-confidence is gone. I learned recently from psychologists that the way a woman encourages his husband boosts his moral system. Husband finished firing. Instead of thanking them, everybody knows importance that when he's shot. So forget about someone. What is the use of beauty without character? Nobody marries beauty. Beauty is in the eyes of the beholder. Who even say you are beautiful? Now, don't worry about a thing. My daughter, I will do what is necessary for everybody knowing that you are a virtuous woman. Next verse. Maybe. But why it is true that I am one of your family redeemers, there is another man who is more closely related to you than I am. Boasikeka stories. Stay here tonight. In the morning, I will talk to him. Oh, parable, maybe you had enough. Yes. You didn't want to present it to the girl that she is the one. You said there is another man. Okay. If she is willing to redeem you very well, let him marry you. But if he is not willing, then as surely as the Lord lives, I will redeem you myself. Now, T, what is happening is that the Jewish people has a certain law. Where your brother Penino and worry, when Timmy worry. So Boaz is interested to marry her, but on Timmy worry because if this guy is interested in Ruth, then this second born cannot marry. So Boaz is going to test the pause to see if these guys lose interest, then automatically it is mine. That's what it is. What's it? That's what he's trying to say. Huh? Let him marry you. But if it is not willing, then as surely as the Lord lives, I will redeem you myself. Now lie down here until morning. The second ninja. Name Pastor. So Ruth lay at Boaz's feet until the morning, but she got up before it was light enough for people to recognize each other. For Boaz has said, no one must know that a woman was here at the threshing floor. Oh, the spirit of secrecy. So then conconsa for name Tron. And kata near maso. Na Ghana near one. Boaz is a Ghanaian. Ghana. Conconsa ni dosho. To Boaz, no mobile who on the board they rule. We will not coffer, not coffer. Young train, I did better me. I a wedding, yeah, the name a P. Simple. Your story, you are time about to know. Can was a man is too late. If you just start, can was a me here, I could far before we bring them. Now, cause any my be brave. T. Let me ask him that down. And name who's a girl you are, the Subai S. Sir.
Amen.
Now, many make a sir. Nyamene wo kasa won se na otoro wa ititiri no nyamene ne wo kasa na kupo se kona kwase se usuban ina be ma ware no atrasi. Peace is a gift from God.
Amen.
You must do something to enjoy it. A man omo da so to omu kunche no omo namo, they have made some sacrifices. They are enjoying the marriage because they didn't lift their voice on their husband. They didn't bring the ego in the man out. Submit yourself to your own husband. Then Boaz said to her, bring your cloak and spread it out. He measured 6 scoops of berry into the cloak and placed it on her back. Then he returned to the town. I love this story. When Ruth went back to her mother-in-law, Naomi asked, what happened, my daughter? Hey, second counseling. Ruth told Naomi everything Boaz has done for her. Yeah. And she said, she gave me this 6 scoops of berry and said, don't go back to your mother-in-law empty-handed. Then Naomi said to her, just be patient, my daughter, until we hear what happens. The man will rest until he has settled things today. Bishop, Naomi wa bing. A country. Our experience. When you say Bema, who could run a kumuma on rested that? Every day, busy. Hallelujah. Tia. Boaz went to the town gate and took a seat there. Just then, the family redeemer he had mentioned came by. So Boaz called out to him, Come over here and sit down, friend. I want to talk to you. So they sat down together. Akwawe said, if this guy is interested in Ruth, Boaz cannot marry her. Then Boaz called 10 leaders from the town and asked them to sit as a witness. But then mini business. And then, as I see, my dear bros. Then Boaz said to the family redeemer, you know Naomi, who came back from Moab. She is selling the land that belonged to our relative Elimelech. Hey, Boaz, I thought I should speak to you about it so that you can redeem it if you wish. If you want the land, then buy it here in the presence of this witness. But if you don't want it, let me know right away because I am next in line to redeem it after you. Ruth Abeya Sase. You will enjoy this one. The man replied, all right, I will redeem it. Then Boaz told him, of course, your purchase of the land from Naomi also requires that you marry Ruth.
the Moabite widow. That way she can have children who will carry on her husband's name and keep the land in the family. Boaz is a smart man. That's how I said the other body cross about. Then I can't redeem it. I can't. He replied, because this might endanger my own estate. You redeem the land, I cannot do it. Now, in those days, it was a custom in Israel for anyone transferring a right of purchase to remove his sandal and hand it to the other party. This publicly validates the transaction. You, Babwa, and the Amobi. So the other family redeemer drew off his sandal as he said to Boaz, you buy the land. Then Boaz said to the elders and to the crowd standing around, you are witnesses that today I have bought from Naomi all the property of Elimelech, Kilion and Mahlon. Watch this. And with the land I have acquired Ruth, the Moabite widow of Mahlon, to be my wife. This way she can have a son to carry on the family. Or maybe you identify name of her dead husband and to inherit the family property here in his hometown. You are all witnesses today. All this in Ruth is not aware. So the marriage was done in a family house before we are calling the woman. The elders and all the people standing in the gate replied, we are witness. May the Lord make this woman who is coming into our home like Rachel and Leah, from whom all the nations of Israel descended. May you prosper in Ephrata and the famous of Bethlehem. Prophecy. And may the Lord give you descendants by this young woman who will be like those of our ancestors, Perez and the son of Tamar and Judah, from the tribe of Judah. So Boaz took Ruth unto his home, and she became his wife. And when she slept with her, the Lord enabled her to become pregnant, and she gave birth to a son. Wait. And the woman of the town said to Naomi, praise the Lord who has provided a redeemer for our family. May this child be famous in Israel. Matthew chapter 1, from verse number 1. The book of the generations of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Watch this. Abraham begat Isaac. Isaac begat Jacob. And Jacob begat Judah, his brethren. Watch this. And Judah begat Phares and Zara of Tamar. And Phares begat Esron. Esron begat Aram. Aram begat Aminadab. Aminadab begat Nahshon. Nahshon begat Salmon. So who is the father of Boaz? Salmon. Salmon begat Boaz with Rahab. Huh? Salmon, have you seen the strange thing about this family? Huh? Have you seen the strange thing about this family? Simon married Rahab, the prostitute. Boaz married Ruth, the Moabite. So, and Salmon begat Boaz, and Boaz begat Obed of Ruth, and Obed begat Jesse. So, from Ruth, gave birth to David's father, that gave birth to David. Yes. And Salmon begat Boaz of Rahab, and Rahab begat Obed, and Obed begat Jesse. Watch this. Watch the line. And Jesse begat David, the king, and David begat Solomon, of her that had been the wife of Uriah. Strange woman. But you see, let me show you something strange about this. All this line, Sarah is not mentioned. Rachel is not mentioned. Rebecca is not mentioned. God, it is not him that will it. It is not him that run it. It is the Lord that shows mercy. And Solomon begat Rehoboam. And Rehoboam begat Abia. And Abia begat Asa. Watch this. And Asa begat Jehoshaphat. So they trace it out to Adam. But from this line, this Boaz guy, from his line, came Jesus Christ. What a story. And it has to do with a woman who was outcast. Let me give a little background on the Moabite. The Moabite are the daughters of Lot,
who climbed the mountain with their father and raped their father. Two nations came, Ammonite and the Moabite. So Ruth came from one line. You can come from everywhere, but by your character and your service to God, God can change your life. Stand to your feet.
God bless you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this message. For further inquiries, contact World Prayer Center, PO Box GP21421, Accra.
And for all inquiries, call these numbers: 0274-009933
plus 233-303-413-705.
Email info@potters.city, and our website is potters.city.